I'm sure we can work things out. Couples have problems, but we shouldn't stop trying. We can go see one of those touchy-feely marriage counselors you talked about. We can work it out. Things will be perfect, just like they used to be.
No, Jeff. Things have been like this forever, and all we do is fight. I don't even get the best Jeff Wilson. The reporters you drink with get him. The people you interview with get him. I just get the one that comes home tired and cranky.
Oh, so it's all my fault. My pursuing a career is wrecking our relationship, right? I'm trying to succeed so you can go back to college and become whatever it is you want to become.
You see, you don't even know.
You mean I don't know what it is today?
Get out. Take your stuff and get out.
Changed your mind in 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3.
There.
Now you see everything moving.
Here, you've got your laptop.
Hi, I'm calling about the ad in the Times. It's gone? Oh, that's too bad. Thanks anyway. Hi, I'm calling about the apartment. Oh, great. $2,500. Well, it's a little too expensive for me right now. Yeah, I have been calling around all morning. No, nothing. Well, thanks anyway. Hi, Lori?
No, wait, don't...
Hello?
Jeff, are you finished Xeroxing and distributing this week's schedule yet?
It's almost finished.
Almost. Look, Jeff, how can you expect to be promoted to reporter if I can't trust you to make copies?
You're right.
Hold on a second. You never agree with me that easily. What's wrong?
Nothing. Really.
Fine. Whatever. Just get those copies distributed by noon.
There he is. Look what I got. Sandwiches. Your favorite. Corned beef on white with mayo. Oh, by the way, you're late. As usual.
Please, it hasn't been a good day.
You look like hell. She threw you out again, huh?
How'd you know?
Well, you obviously haven't been home to change. Or bathe. I figured it had to be that.
I'm walking around all night long. I ended up in the Brooklyn Promenade just staring out in the distance.
Oh, my poor little French lieutenant's woman.
This is serious. God, why am I put up with you?
Because you love me. And because this is the 90s, and my people are in. Well, actually, we're out, which is in. You know, being out, that is. God, it's all so confusing.
Oh, Rich, what am I going to do? My wife threw me out of the house.
Listen, you're not the only one with problems. My mother's on my case again, big time.
Well, she's still pestering you to settle down with a nice Jewish boy?
Yeah, she said, I want you to meet my stylist, Jerome. He's one of your people, dear.
My people? That night I dreamt Jerome was leading all the gays through the desert on their way to freedom and a new hairstyle in the promised land. San Francisco?
No, you know, South Beach. With all that sand. That woman will not rest until I meet Mr. Wright.
Do you remember when she told you I'd be perfect for you?
Oh my God. She still doesn't believe you're straight. Never will.
working for the style section, going to the opera and ballet all the time, and that all about E! Video. Now that's just pushing it.
Well, at least she went to Florida.
Now she can only kvetch from long distance.
That's kvetch, you goy. Hey, I've got an idea.
What is it now, Einstein?
No, hear me out. You need a place to stay. I need Mr. Light to move in with me so that I can keep that apartment. You talk about Mr. Convergence.
You want me to pretend to be your husband?
Yeah, it'll be easy. And you'll get one half of a two-bedroom apartment on West End Avenue with a view of the Hudson.
Forget it.
My God, I'd pretend to be straight to get that. Even without that view.
You are crazy.
Oh, come on.
No! I'm not gonna lie anymore just to please others.
Oh, you go, girl!
You see? You're a natural.
Damn, look at the time. I gotta get back to work. If Maureen catches me late one more time, she will can me.
Oh, she'd never do that. She wants to jump your bones. She's been after you since you got that job. Well, think about it, okay? Will you at least do that?
Decided to grace us with your presence, or is that the ghost of career past?
This is not my day.
Do you remember what I said would happen if you were late again?
I know. You said you'd fire me.
No, my exact words were, the closest you'll come to a newsroom is watching reruns of the Mary Tyler Moore Show.
That may have been the full quote, yes.
So, what sorry excuse do you have for me this time?
My wife threw me out of the house last night, and I went to talk it through with Rich.
That's the truth.
Well, that is a problem, isn't it? So, is this it for the two of you, finally? I mean, it's no secret that you've been touch and go for months.
Well, she said she needs some space.
Of course she does. And so do you. A chance to see what else is out there. So, this means that you're available.
Well,
I've made no secret about my attraction to you, have I? You know, Jeff, I can make things happen for you. Big things.
Well, listen, I'm certainly flattered, but I...
But what? Am I too old for you? Too aggressive? Too forward?
Too female.
What?
I'm gay.
What?
Yeah, that's what Lori and I have been arguing about all this time. I can't live a lie anymore. I'm gay. And I'm in love.
With whom?
Rich.
Rich. Well, I'm off class with Rich, drawing the nail form, and he's never mentioned this.
Well, he's discreet, and I've asked him not to say anything to anyone. So please don't bring it up with him. Anyway, we're moving in together. Go figure, huh?
You know, I always thought that you were gay. I mean, come on, Jeff, you know all the arias from La Bohème by heart. But you said you were married, so I figured I was wrong. How long do you think you could keep it up?
Well, can't pull one over on you, I guess.
Why even try? I've been around the track a few times, you know.
Say somewhere outside that.
Did you say something?
Force of habit, I guess. Here's your room. Lori?
I need to talk to you.
I'm sorry I hung up on you before. It just that...
No, you don't have to explain. It's okay.
Are you doing okay?
Well, I'd be in a lot better spirits if I could take a shower and had access to the rest of my clothes. I'd be overjoyed if I could even spend an hour at home.
Today's your lucky day. I need you to be my husband, and... No, it doesn't mean I'm willing to try again.
It just means I need your help.
Okay, well, when you make it sound so appealing, how can I resist?
Will you just listen to me? I just got off the phone with Bob. He's coming for a visit.
He's in town on business. Some
includes the manufacturers' convention. He wants to have dinner with us here.
Oh, sure. Mr. Perfect's coming into town and you want me to kiss his butt for the evening?
Just because he's a success doesn't mean you have to hate him.
I don't hate him for being a success.
I hate him for the way your parents treat him. Bob's this, Bob's that.
Talk about choosing favorite child.
Look, my parents are the way they are, but I'm not about to blame it on him. Anyway, if you're not there, he's going to wonder what's wrong, and I can't
have him telling my parents.
I can't believe you're still looking for their approval.
You know it's got nothing to do with that. I just can't risk Bob telling my parents that we've broken up. I can't afford another apartment.
Don't cry. Damn it, you know what? I can't take that. Okay, Lori. Oh, God. Okay, I'll be there right after work.
So, you two look great. New York agrees with you, I see.
Sure does. We couldn't be happier. The apartment's great, too, isn't that right, babe?
Oh, well, I'm hardly ever here. But it sure is nice.
Hi, who is it?
Hello.
It's Rich and Maureen, Jeff's boss. Why don't you two move over to the living room?
Oh, God. What a place. If I didn't get such a great job offer in Maine, I would have fought you for it. But hey, the deal's deal, right? First one married gets the apartment.
All right, for the zillion time, why on earth are we barging in on that?
We reporters call it fact-checking. And by the way, I want to find out what's going on between you and Jeff.
Hi.
Hi, Lori.
Tonight.
Sorry for popping in, but Maureen insisted.
Class was cut short. The male model had a little problem.
Problem?
Oh my God, he kept getting his huge erection. You should have seen it.
Yeah, well, whatever. Rich, you remember Bob, Lori's brother?
Oh yes, good to see you. It's been ages.
And this is Maureen Rowe, my supervisor.
You must be so disappointed to hear about Jeff.
Disappointed?
Yeah, I told him about that yet. You see, I haven't been promoted to reporter yet, Bob. I'm still a lowly news clerk. Why don't you guys have a seat on the sofa and take a load off yourself?
Oh, I see you haven't told him yet. Well, why don't we scoot on out of here? You were right. We shouldn't have barged in like this. Why don't we leave and leave these three to have a nice family reunion?
Oh, no, don't be silly. Why don't you two join us for dinner?
Oh, no, we couldn't.
Oh, yes, we could. Well, sit down, Maureen.
You shouldn't worry so much, Jeff. New York can be a tough city to crack in the newspaper industry.
Oh, and you know all about the newspaper industry, do you?
Relax, Jeff. He's just trying to help.
Bob is right. I told you that most people have to start out in rinky-dink papers and claw their way up to New York.
Well, Jeff was always one for beating the odds.
Well, I'm glad I have someone's support.
Don't be such a sourpuss.
Need a drink.
See? You do have the makings of a journalist. You're halfway to being an alcoholic.
What is this? Pick on Jeff night?
Yeah. Well, let's give the spotlight to someone else. So, tell me, Bob, what brings you to town?
I'm here on business.
Oh, so it's a short stay.
Just overnight.
Too bad.
Oh, story of my life. Can't hold a man for longer than a few hours.
And he's rich. Your claws are showing.
Yeah. And you're being silly. You have one of the best men to yourself.
Now is not the time.
Oh. Did I put my foot in my mouth again?
I think you're embarrassing Rich.
Oh, it's my knight in shining armor.
Oh, hey. What a guy. You know, if you were Jewish, you'd be perfect. By the way, I am available.
Rich, Will you have some decency? Jeff is right here.
So? It's only Jeff.
Yeah, Maureen. Rich is just being rich. Doesn't bother me one bit.
Well, it should. I don't understand you. Where's the morality? Lori, I don't blame you for throwing him out.
What? You threw him out?
We still love each other, just that, you know, we can't live together. All the little things just seem to, you know, build and build and build. But I'll always love you.
You mean that, Lori?
Yes, I do.
This is too weird for me.
So, now you're still up in Maine, right?
Yes, but I'm moving back to New York. My last relationship broke up because I lived there and they lived in Washington.
What relationship would that be, Bob?
Well, maybe he doesn't want your parents to meet her.
Why not?
Well, considering how things have, you know...
What do you mean? What do you mean? If you have something to say, just say it.
Considering how they have this perfect picture of how everything and everyone and every detail should be, and how they can't even look at reality or the truth, even if it's staring at them in the face.
Give that man a cigar.
God, get that man a therapist. You know, repressed anger is not good for you at all. Thank God I'm a sucker for hard luck cases.
Slut. Can't you be happy spending the rest of your life with a great guy like Jeff?
Well, yeah, sure. If you were into that. Face it, Maureen. You're the one with the obsession over Jeff.
You want Jeff?
Does it matter? It's a little too late for that. I don't know what you did that drove him to turn gay.
I'm not gay.
Well, he does like the opera and show tunes, but I can assure you he's not gay.
But I am.
What?
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 That's what I've been trying to tell you. I'm moving back to New York. I need to live in a more gay-friendly place.
Welcome to New York, sailor. Can I show you around?
Wait 1 minute. You lied to me.
Look, I'm sorry I lied to you. I didn't know what else to do. You're my boss. I felt uncomfortable.
Well, now I'm embarrassed.
Look, I'm not some uptight wasp who can't have fun, you know. Well, I'm not. But Maureen, you just went too far. I want to be taken seriously and have the chance to make it as a reporter. And even if I don't make it, I at least wanted that chance.
Look, Jeff, believe me, tight funds or not, you would not be in my department for long if you couldn't cut it.
I'd take that as a compliment.
Well, it was. And you do deserve a shot. There's a trainee spot opening up in the spring, and I'll recommend you for it. There'll be no guarantees, but you'll get your fair chance. Then you better start taking your work responsibilities seriously.
I will. And I think we deserve another chance, too, Lori.
Oh, Jeff, I don't know.
Look, I know we need some outside help, but let me move back in. And who knows? Maybe we'll get another chance at getting married. For real this time.
Dummy!
I think we better come clean. Jeff and I were never really married.
I know.
Do?
You do?
How?
Well, the story you told Mom and Dad about how you and Jeff eloped, it was so obvious.
What do you mean, obvious?
It was the exact storyline of the Joni and Chachi elopement episode from Happy Days. It didn't bother to change a thing. I'm surprised you didn't mention Pinky Tuscadero as your maid of honor.
So unfair, isn't it? These straight people with their bizarre lifestyles have no dramatic creativity whatsoever. All this to live on First Avenue. I mean, as if the Upper East Side were worth lying about. I mean, the Village, maybe, but...
So why didn't you ever say anything?
I figured you'd tell me when you're ready. Sort of like you did tonight, and sort of like I did.
You're not gonna tell Mom and Dad?
Oh, no way. With our folks, some things are better left unsaid, if you know what I mean. And I think that you two should try to make it last. You do have something special. Besides, I like Jeff. He keeps our parents on their toes.
Thanks, Bob.
Well, look, Bob, if you need a place to stay...
Thanks. But I'm a pretty resourceful guy. I'll find my own place.
Well, I happen to know of a guy with a nice two-bedroom to share on the Upper West Side. The place is magnificent, and the rent is super cheap, but...
But nothing. How can I get it?
Say fetch for me.
Kvetch.
No!
Kvetch.
Kvetch.
Bobby. I think this could be the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Thank you.